This is the Strat-O-Matic Baseball Excel 1970-73 Carryover League. Brought to you by the Shrimp Trawler YouTube channel. The World Series. The Oakland Athletics versus the Cincinnati Reds. Game 4.
Welcome back, baseball fans, to Game 4 of the 1970-73 World Series from Oakland. The Cincinnati Reds and the Oakland A's. The Cincinnati Reds are winning the series 2-1 at this point. Losing Game 1 at home. Gullett losing to Blue and then winning games 2 and 3 behind Dick Bosman and Mr. Gary Nolan. We're back to the game one starters. This time on the road, it'll be Don Gullett for the Reds. And for the Oakland A's, it'll be Vida Blue through a complete game in game one. He needs to win today for the A's to even the series at 2 apiece. Let's get started. Leading off, Bobby Tolan. 3-11's a walk. Double A Steeler, and Gene Tennis is catching. We've been waiting for this opportunity for Tolan. He hasn't had it yet. He does now, the steal. And he rolls a 14. He's going to be safe. 17 plus two arm, 19 makes it a 16 chance, and he makes it. It's Pete Rose, 65. Skies to right. Tony Perez, 1-6. Tony Perez, let's take a look at his card. The 1970 Perez card, having an MVP year. Finished second in the overall voting to Hank Aaron, was the Red MVP, and they have a 2-0 lead. Johnny Bench, 46, that single one is 7 off of Blue, lines out on a 10. And Lee May, 45, double one of 4, base hit, getting to Blue early here. Batting 6th, it'll be Ted Savage. 2-6, take a look at this card, Ted Savage. 1970 Milwaukee Brewer card. Signed as a free agent by Cincinnati and as the DH and can play left field, but 2-6 is triple, 1-18, rolls a 9, it's a triple. And the Reds keep going here. 3 runs have scored, Savage at third, 2 outs for Concepcion. 1-3, skies to right. The Reds got momentum with the game 2 win and are riding that in the beginning of game number 4. It's up to the Oaktown A's to respond. Leading off for them is Burke Campanaris. 35's a walk. Campanaris has picked his spots against Bench. Down 3 runs early. It's not a spot, I don't think. He'll stay at first. For Sal Bando. 58. This is second X, and this is Tommy Helms. A big defensive play here on the 1-10 second baseman, and he turns the double play. And that's why he would steal Campanaris. Bench sets that up. Reggie, 48 off Gullett's a pop to third. Top of 2, it'll be Tommy Helms. 1-9 for Tommy is a sky to center field. John Vukovich, 67, is a K. With 2 outs now, Bobby Tolan got the thing started. A 3-5, single off his own card with 2 outs. He'll try and get into scoring position with another stolen base, and he rolls an 8 and does so. So he's been the key thus far. Runner at second, 2 outs for Pete Rose. 62, rolls to the pitcher. Bottom of 2, here's Gene Tennis. 33, flies to right. Joe Rudy, 2-7, rolls to third. Mike Hegan, 1-6, is a K. We'll go to the third inning now, to Tony Perez. 2-7, is a K. Johnny Bench, 2-5, rolls to third, and with 2 outs, it's Lee May. 58 is a strikeout. Blue settles down now after that first inning. Angel Mingual, 46, skies the left. Stan Swanson, 3-11, rolls to third. And Dick Green, 45, rolls to second. Don Gullett got through the lineup with just a walk. Go to the fourth. It's Ted Savage. 110, flies left. Dave Concepcion, 5'11". Second X, this is Dick Green at 2 at second base, E12. But he boots the ball, an E12 second baseman. That's a big play there. Allows Helms an opportunity to hit and run. The speedy Concepcion at first, he'll take it. On the hit and run, it's fielder's choice. And I have Helms at first. And you have John Vukovich, 59, rolls to second. Bottom of the fourth, it's Campanaris. 49 off Goet, pops to first. Bando, 56, is a K. And with two outs, it's Reggie. 68, second X. Again, Tommy Helms, a 1-E-10 at second base. Yeah, and he has been the glue to the infield defense of the Reds. 1-E-10 second baseman. We saw how effective that Bud Harrelson was as a 1-E-17 shortstop last year in that World Series run for the Mets. And Helms is doing the trick for the Reds this year in the middle infield. Top of the fifth, it's Bobby Tolan. Trying to go in for the third time. 58 is a strikeout. Pete Rose, 2-5, base hit for Rose. B stealer being held on. Not going to steal with Perez and bench up. 2-10, that is center, B question mark. And with two outs, does Rose dare to steal with Johnny at the plate because he hasn't yet this year and they want to try something? You got a plus two arm of tennis, and he's going to do it. Rose is going to attempt to steal, and he's going to be safe. Barely. A 13, 14, 15 to 12, so he gets to second base. Now all Johnny Bench needs is a single for the RBI. The pitch to Johnny Bench. 211, just misses it and grounds it short. But Rose makes his first stolen base of the year in game four of the World Series. Bottom of the fifth, let's pause a moment. First station, identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Okay, bottom of the fifth, Oakland. Slow out of the blocks, not doing much at home. Did most of their damage in game one and been kind of stodgy since. Stagnant offense, need to get it going here. Gene Tennis, 38 is a walk. Joe Rudy, 2-8 is a pop to short. Mike Hegan, 3-11 is a fly to right, and with two outs, it's Angel Mangual. 66 finally hits the gullet card. That's their first hit. 66 is double 1-5. It's a base hit. They got runners on the corners with two outs, and the tying run is Stan Swanson. 58 off of gullet. This is second X again. Really pushing this thing, and he gets it again. The GBA right there for the 1-E-10 second baseman. Oh, how important that middle infield defense can be when you're trying to win the whole World Series. We go to the sixth inning. It'll be Lee May. 2-4, rolls short. Ted Savage, 54, center X. Mangual is a 3-E-4 in center field, makes the grab. And Concepcion, 63, pitcher X in blue, is an E0. Don't roll my E0 pitchers. If you're the home team and you're an E0, automatic GBA. So the inning's over. Very crisply and quickly played game four in Oakland. A's need a rally, or they could be down 3-1. It'll be Dick Green, bottom of the sixth. 1-9 is a walk. It'll be Burt Campanaris. 6-10 off of gullet. Short X. This is Concepcion. 8-2, E21. At short. 8-2, E21 at short. AGBA! And you're seeing the improvement of the Red defense since their last attempt of going to the World Series of 2 years ago. They clearly have gotten better. And, they even have John Vukovich, a one at third base, though he's hitting 166. That's how much they value defense now. With two outs, it's Salvando. 5-11. Pitcher X. Gullet is an E6. Pitcher to E6. And Gullet makes an error. First mistake of the day for a Red player. And now with two outs, it's Reggie Jackson. 2-8 is a K off of Reggie's card. And it is Gullet with a one-hit shutout through six frames. Pitching better than he did in game one. Vida Blue, a little puzzled. He gave up a bad first inning, has been sailing along since, but his team's down three runs. Vida Blue is the starter 9, while Gullet's the starter 7. We're in the 7th. Let me Tommy Helms. 4-4 off of blue. Homer 1-5 fly ball, and he misses it. Flies out. Doesn't have power anyway. John Vukovic, 2-3, rolls to short. And Bobby Tolan of the Bells, trying to get on for the third time. 3-10 is a hit by the pitch, and you know he's going to try it, folks. He's going to try for his third stolen base. He's been pent up thus far with no steals the first three games, and now he's going to get his stealing in when he can. He rolls a 9, and he's at second base for Pete Rose. Runner at second with two outs. The pitch to Pete. 67 off of blue is a strikeout. Pete Rose cannot come through for his beloved Reds. 3-0 though, they have the lead. Stretch time here in Oakland. We are enjoying, of course, Shuggy Otis's Inspiration Information double LP, Wings of Love, Out of My Head, Fling, Special, Give Me Something Good. There's a bunch of great, wonderful tunes on this record. The great Shuggy Otis. Back to the game in the bottom of the seventh. Don Gullett is the story of the day. After Gary Nolan gave up just one run in the complete game in Game 3, Gullett is following it up with a similar masterpiece. Can he finish it? Clay Carroll has had plenty of rest, plenty of opportunities, chomping at the bit. Get me in the game. I can close this thing out. But it'll be Gene Tennis leading off in the seventh. 2-7 is a K. Joe Rudy. 4-10 off of Gullett. This is center X. This is Tolan. He's a 2-9 in center field. And that's a two-base error. Now the Reds are getting sloppy as soon as I complimented them. For their defense, with the Concepcion and double play and the Helms double play, we get a Gullett error, and now we get a Bobby Tolan error. You can't do that if you're trying to win the World Series. Can't make these unforced errors, these double faults. It'll be Mike Hegan. 2-8 for Hegan. Let's take a look at the Mike Hegan card. Hits lefties and righties fine. The A's had all sorts of first basemen fall into their laps in this era. They couldn't get Mike Epstein. They couldn't get Don Mincher. Well, they did get Mike Hegan, the third choice to be their first baseman. And he drops in a single dot, and the A's are on the board. And the A's will bring the tie run to the plate. And it's Angel Mangual. And if you're thinking quick hook here, don't worry about it, folks. We're sparky. We weren't sparky in Game 3 because we wanted Nolan to go the distance, but we're going to go heavy sparky now. I'm not going to be accused of not being sparky. So we are going to load these bullpen pitchers one after the other. We got three straight righties. None are particularly good either. Mangual, Swanson, and Dick Green. And on your lefties on the bench, Joshua French and Donaldson aren't good either. So we'll go with... In a choice of Bourbon and Granger, I think we're going to go with... it's like tossing a coin, really, I mean. We're going with Bourbon. And that'll probably be the mistake. I should have gone with Granger. We're going to go with Bourbon because we're going to get some left-handed pinch hitters coming up. If I knew I was facing righties, I'd go with Granger. But Bourbon is a bit more balanced pitcher. He'll come on in the seventh. And Mangual, you're thinking, he does have power. It's a homer 1-9 on the Bourbon card. Joshua doesn't even have power. Donaldson doesn't have power. French doesn't have power. None of the players on the bench even have power. They can't even tie the game. So Mangual's actually going to bat now. He probably would have been pinch hit for had they gone to Granger, but Mangual will bat because it's Bourbon with power and a chance of homering off the Bourbon card. So the runner at first and one out in a 3-1 game. Here's the pitch to Angel Mangual. 48 off Bourbon. Single 1-13. He rolls a 14 and misses it by one. The Reds are living a charmed life in some of these critical moments here thus far in the series. It's up to the A's to stop that from happening. Now the problem, if you go to a lefty pinch hitter now, you're stuck because you got nothing but lefties behind that. And so Stan Swanson will actually bat here off of Bourbon. I mean, if you bring in any of these lefties, Joshua French or Donaldson, the Reds will counter with Jim Strickland. So, Swanson will hit away. Let's look at the Stan Swanson card. He's got on base both ways, really. He's a 250 hitter. So he's not horrible. He's just, you know, 250 hitter. So, there you go. One every four times, he looks great, right? So here's the moment here. We're runner at first and two outs in the seventh inning. The pitch to Stan Swanson. 58 off of Rabone's card again. Double one to two, single dot dot. It's a single dot dot. And now you got trouble. You got Dick Green. With runners on the corners, let's take a look at Dick Green's card. Dick Green lifted some weights in the offseason because he has 12 bombs. Enough power with his 71 card. Probably has 12 homers in 71. I'm going to bet in the years 72, 73, and 74 combined, he didn't have 12 homers. But he has 12 home runs here. Bourbon got a break on the first batter, but he didn't on the second batter. And Dick Green will swing away versus Pedro Bourbon with two outs in the seventh. Here's the pitch. 49 off Bourbon. Another hit off his card. To right field. That'll make it a one-run game. Swanson will not get thrown out at third base. The A's have the tie run at second, lead run at first. And now it's gotten a lot more interesting as it's Bert Campanaris, a legitimate hitter. What do you do now, Bourbon? This is your inning. You got us into this mess. It's up to you to get us out of this somehow. Two on, two outs in a 3-2 classic. The pitch to Bert Campanaris. 2-11 is a pop to third. He finally gets an out. Got give up two hits. Could have been three hits and got two outs. The seventh inning is over. It is 3-2 Cincinnati. Another classic one-run game. My goodness. No bench. The bench was not gone to, which means that all those lefties we talked about are still available should Clay Carroll come in late in this one. So that was a shrewd move by the A's not to do that now. So in the top of the eighth, no defense to bring in, no changes to bring in. Vita Blue will continue, and it'll be Tony Perez at the big homer in the first inning. Pitch to Tony. 45 off the blue card is double one to four. It's a base hit for Tony Perez. Johnny Bench, today he's a quiet 0-3. Big moment here for Johnny. 69 off of blue flies to left. Now you got Lee May. You go from 40 home runs to 45 home runs to 39 home runs. Blue's starting to see things. I believe how tough this red lineup is. Runner at first, one out. The pitch to Lee May. 2-8! And let's look at the Lee May card. You hit his column here. 2-8 is double one of four. It's a single dot dot. Runners on the corners. There's good news for Vita Blue. He's a starter nine, so he's not in danger of breaking here unless he gives up a multitude of base runners, and he hasn't. You got Ted Savage. Really good against lefties. We saw the card earlier, but a lot of those walks, which would not score a run. The A's will bring their infield up for Ted Savage. Here is the pitch. 1-4 is a fly left B question mark. This is Tony Perez. Decent runner at this age. A 12. Yeah, that's not bad for that age. He's 1970. You know, he's not a bad runner until later in the decade, early 80s. But 1 to 12. 13, 1 of 14, he can run because, believe it or not, Joe Rudy, never known for a great arm, often had a plus 1 or plus 2 arm. His arm is 0, so it's 1 of 14 for the insurance run. Perez is going to tag up. Here is the throw to the plate. We'll look right here next to advance. And a 2 is rolled. And it is Tony Perez chugging down the third baseline to make this a 4-2 game as Rudy cannot get enough on the throw. And Ted Savage has two RBIs today. 4-2. Runner at first. Two outs for Dave Concepcion. 67 off blue is a K. A two-run game with six outs to get. Bando, Jackson, Tennis, Rudy, and Hegan. I think Bourbon will go to Bando, and then if he gets on, we'll go with a lefty to face Reggie. Bourbon has been kind of shaky today. He'll pitch to Bando. Here's the pitch. 5-11 off the Bourbon card. Short X. This is going to be Mr. Concepcion at 2E21 shortstop. And he makes the play. Good defense there. Up and down day for the red defense. Started hot, got sloppy, and that's another nice play. And that's going to do it for Bourbon. Figure I've got as much as I can out of the guy. A little shaky there with those two hits. Could have been three hits. And now we're going to take use of our lefty situational guy, Jim Strickland, a guy the Reds acquired from the Minnesota Twins. As the Twins could not have all these lefties, they had Jimmy Cott, they had Mr. Ron Paranowski, Pete Reichert. So Strickland became available, and the Reds said, we need a lefty setup guy. The Reds' bullpen had traditionally been all right-handed dominant, with the Pat Darcy's and Raleigh Eastwick's of the world, and yeah, Granger, Bourbon, and Clay Carroll, and that sort of thing. So Strickland will come on in the eighth with one out and five outs remaining in this game to face Reggie Jackson. Let's take a look at Reggie's card. Definitely gets on more versus righties, but he still has plenty of power. Reggie Jackson, your 1973 American League Most Valuable Player. Here's the pitch to Reggie. 48 off Strickland as a walk. He's also an ace stealer. But you're not going to steal off a bench, particularly when you're not even the tie run. Gene Tennis is the batter. We had the situation before. He has more homers against righties. Strickland's home run chance on his card is just a 1-2. And I still want to get a little bit closer to the end for Carroll. Maybe a 4-out save. So it will be Strickland to Tennis in this situation. The pitch to Gene Tennis. 35 is single. One, it's sort of an automatic walk versus a righty. But against a lefty, it's single 1-8. Line out to short, but a 1 is rolled. A tough break for both teams there. It wasn't an automatic thing for the A's, but he gets the single anyway. And the tying runs are on, and now you're in nowhere land again. You're in nowhere land again. And I think at this point, when you're in nowhere land, it's time to go to Mr. Clay Carroll and ask him to get five outs. Something that I wouldn't be crazy about, particularly when Mike Hegan comes up and all those lefties come up in the bottom of the lineup. But Clay Carroll, his story, 2 years has not given up a run in 2020, or yeah, what year is this, 2022? Yeah. In 2021 and 2022, he did not give up a run in the regular season. But in the playoffs, he has. 2 years in a row. So there's that. Big moment here, of course, for Clay Carroll. He would be the pitcher of record if he blows it here, as it's a two-run lead with two men on base. Clay Carroll will come in with runners at first and second and one out. All of the defense, the Reds have is in the game. Joe Rudy's a right-handed batter. And here is the pitch to Joe Rudy. 2-11 is a pop to third. And with two outs, here's your batter. And you get a couple ways of looking at this thing. There's Mike Hegan. Not a good matchup for Carroll. The worst matchup other than Reggie for the next 6, 7 batters. But with a two-run lead, you're probably not going to get a three-run homer here. He does a 1-5 chance on 6 and a 1-11 chance on 6-4 on the Carroll card. But a great chance of getting a single or a walk here. For Mike Hegan, big moment for the A's, down 2-1 in the series with 2 on and 2 outs in the 8th. The pitch to Mike Hegan. 1-11, he misses it and skies the center field. Now Mike Hegan made the final out in Game 3, and oh boy, now it's the A's starting to feel it. Starting to feel, you know, the choke coming in. They won Game 1, and they've gone to the tank for the next 2 games and 8 innings. We'll go to the 9th. Vida Blue, no reason to take him out. He's a starter 9, and he arrives in this inning only giving up the 4 runs on a small amount of hits. What, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 hits? It'll be Tommy Helms to lead it off. 35 for Tommy Helms as a grounder to short. John Vukovich, 110, flies to left. And Bobby Tolan, nice day, getting on base in the first inning, getting that early Reds rally going, and stealing 3 times today. Pitch to Tolan. 59 off of blue is a short X. This is Campanaris. He's a 3, E22, and he makes the play. We'll go to the bottom of the 9 for Clay Carroll. Now, all those lefty pinch hit guys I mentioned, they are available. Again, the only lefty, Strickland, was used to face Reggie, and then he failed miserably. And again, tomorrow in Game 5, Ross Grimsley is the starter. So there is no other left-handed help for the Reds at this point, which means that the next three batters could all be left-handed off of Clay Carroll, starting with Mangual, Swanson, and Green. You could go with Joshua, Donaldson, and French, and they will. It'll be Von Joshua will lead off as a pinch hitter. Let's take a look at him. They're not impressive, but they bat left-handed. And Carroll's not as good against lefties. So here is Von Joshua leading off in the bottom of the ninth, down by 2. The pitch. 69 off of Carroll is a clean single to center field. Would have been a walk against the righty. Batting for Stan Swanson. I think they're going to go to a guy who doesn't hit... The guy who gets into less double plays, which is Jim French. Take a look at Jim French here. He's normally the leadoff guy against righties with his on-base percentage. Getting on base will put the lead run at the plate, the winning run at the plate, I should say. So that's why French is going to bat with a runner at first and nobody out, batting for Stan Swanson. It's Jim French, the pitch. 64 off of the Clay Carroll card. This is homer 1-13. Would be gone. This game would be tied, but nobody on Oakland's bench has power. Note to the Oakland bench, get somebody who has power next year. So that becomes a single dot dot for Jim French. And hold the phone, folks. The lefties are killing Carroll. Runners on the corners, nobody out. Don't see why you would let Dick Green bat here. I know he could hit a three-run homer. But you're going to have Campanaris, Bando, and Reggie coming up probably to win this thing. So I'm going to go with the next left-handed pinch hitter. Let's take a look at John Donaldson now. He's got a chance on 3-5 of ending this game with homer 1-15. And Clay Carroll, again, the playoffs are a different animal than the regular season. They are going to play it back with runners on the corners with a two-run lead. The pitch to John Donaldson. 65 off of Clay Carroll, triple, 1-18. This ball game is tied up at 4. Again, the left-handed batters, there is no answer. There is no solution. There's Wayne Granger is your solution, and he's not much better. As the A's have found the key to getting to the end of these games. Get to Carroll from the left side. It's worked brilliantly. And now they have the winning run up at third. And you got Campanaris, Bando, and Jackson. Carroll is a relief 3. He's not broken. Though his heart might be, and the Reds' hearts might be. This is a complete fold up here. The infield comes up for Campanaris. A bunter. I don't think I'm going to squeeze nobody out. Campanaris will hit away with the infield up. Here's the pitch. 56 off of Carroll is a K. Now, Reggie could be walked if we get that far. It'll be Bando. The infield's up for Bando. Worst case, maybe he walks him. Runner at third, one out. The pitch to Sal Bando. 1-5 is a base hit into center field, and your Oakland A's have walked off game 4. Just like that, and oh my goodness, folks, it happened again. It's happening again in the Reds and Clay Carroll. He's untouchable in the regular season and touchable when it matters most. It is a 5-4 victory for the Oakland A's, getting 3 runs in the bottom of the ninth from Von Joshua, Jim French, and John Donaldson. Can't do that. Can't lose a World Series that way, Cincinnati. I mean, come on. But yeah, it's all tied up. Game 4. Each team has the perfect scenario in 4 games, winning at home and winning on the road. Vita Blue gets his second win, one on home and the road. 7 hits, 4 runs. All happened early. They were all earned. Walked 2, struck out 6, got his complete game. Clay Carroll takes the loss. 4 hits, three runs and a K in the ninth. Jim Strickland came in, faced a couple batters, didn't get anybody out, hitting a walk. And frankly, Bourbon as well. Bourbon gave up two hits, should have given up three hits. His inherited runner scored as well. So not a good look there for the Red bullpen altogether. It was pretty bad. Don Gullett's got to be shaking his head. He struck out Gene Tennis lead off the seventh inning, and then Bobby Tolan drops a fly ball, and from there, that's your ball game. The Reds just choked this thing away in a horrible manner. Don Gullett's line. Two hits, two runs, none are earned, three walks, four strikeouts, no decision. 1009, 0108 and a third, 5947, 5947, 2645, or 526. That is game four of the World Series. It has been a wild series, and we're tied up as well. Reds still have home field advantage, though. And we will go to a game five. Thanks for checking it out. We'll see game five tomorrow. Have a good one, and we'll see you then.